There are five nations in FM22 that you need to scout every time. Starting off in the fifth ranked nation, we go to Argentina, the country of Diego Armando Maradona and his successor Lionel Messi. I have run a simulation of 10 seasons and then documented all the players listed in the Next Gen 50 award each season and the nation they come from. The logic behind being that if they can produce a lot of nominees for the award, it means they can produce a lot of promising talented young players, in turn offering a wide variety of wonderkids and talents. Phew, that was long. Argentina has listed 14 such nominees, which means that at least one wonderkid appeared in the game every season. But it has to be noted that Argentina has not featured in the list for the award until season 3, when they have featured two: Jose Vasquez, a versatile defender, and the very physical and talented right back or center back in Ricardo Albarracín. Now, I know the names don't tell you much, since they are regions, but studying the profiles of the generated wonderkids can give us an idea of what we might expect. As we all know, the dynamic rating plays a big role in FM22 in defining the level of youth players being produced by a nation, and in turn, it can be influenced by various factors like league nation development, financial situation in the country, and so on. The dynamic youth rating is on a scale of 1 to 200, and Argentina starts with 140. In a span of 10 seasons, L'Albi Celeste did not really move their youth rating. However, they have produced 14 proven wonderkids. We move to the first European country on our list. The Azzurri are a reputable nation in the world of football and are the 8th nation in the world's pecking order. They have matched the 14 wonderkids produced by Argentina and added one more for good measure, nurturing 15 such talents.
Can I raise a limit?
No.
I'll play the whole table then. Hey, mama, don't you treat
me wrong. In 2021, the likes of Nicolo Zaniolo, Alessandro Bastoni or Sebastiano Esposito dominate the scenery. But sending your scouts in this nation can provide you with such talents like Giovanni Calderoni, Mirko Nani or Giorgio Vallia. Imagine if this type of players was produced by the Italian clubs, how the youngsters you could find could look like. The nation's youth rating is around 144 during the first season and did go to 145 in my save during the 10 seasons. This is not a major improvement overall, but the Italian clubs are a machine of producing young talents, and I do believe that regardless of the team you manage, you can find suitable youngsters in Italy. We keep the vibe of Southern Europe and arrive in España. La Roja are a nation bolstering young talents and can brag with finding players like Iker Casillas, Carles Puyol, Sergio Ramos, David Silva, Raul González and many, many more. The team generated 16 wonderkids in a span of 10 seasons, and Jacobo, Alex Valera or Mauricio Sandoval are just a very small part of what the Spanish clubs can produce. Spain have featured in the Next Gen 50 award list every season between 1 and 9, missing just in the 10th one. The nation's youth rating is around 145 in the first season, and it did go to 147 in my save during the 10 seasons. Also, Spain has improved the 7th place to 5th in the world rankings during the simulation, which suggests an increase in the quality of players being capped for the national team. Overall, I believe that sending your scouts on Spanish football territory is not at all a waste. What is also not a waste is subscribing to the channel, and by hitting the bell notification ensures you are not missing any video. We now arrive in the country of Samba and Joga Bonito. Naming all the best talented players Brazil has had in the footballing history would take a lot of time, but that history can tell us a lot of their present and their future. If you are on the chase of finding the next Ronaldinho, Neymar, Roberto Carlos or the famous Ronaldo, I would encourage you to do so with all the scouts you have. Just send them out! Brazil should just be scouted by default. But for the purpose of the video, I should let you know that they have produced 18 wonderkids featuring in the Next Gen 50 award list. This is almost 2 wonderkids per season and countless others young promising talents. Now, I know that buying wonderkids from Brazil could prove itself costly if you don't move fast, but I think that every penny spent on Brazilian wonderkids is worth it.
Show me the money.
Players like Romildo, Bocau and Da Silva have been produced by the Brazilian clubs in my simulation, and tell me you wouldn't want them in your teams. Brazil has a youth rating at around 163 in the first season and did not improve it too much in my save. But the South American nation is without a doubt full of footballing talent, and it would be a waste if you wouldn't scout it, more so if you would have the means to do it. For number 1, we have England. Not the United Kingdom, just England. And I need to mention this as Wales and Scotland were also on my list. The English nation starts with a youth rating of around 135, and in a span of 10 seasons, they have increased it to 137. But they have produced 19 wonder kids. That's very, very close to 2 wonder kids each season. Players such as Kate Gordon, Mark Butterworth, and Luke Hume were produced by the English clubs. Just like Brazil, you do need to have quite good finances in order to afford buying wonder kids from England, but the same as the case for Seleção, these players can make the difference for your club. Sending scouts in England would be a wise choice in my opinion. Besides nation scouting, you could also focus on clubs, leagues or competition scouting. If you wish to know which are the best wonder kids academies in FM22, make sure to watch this video here. I'm Alex and I thank you for watching today's video. As always, dear audience, stay safe, relax and have fun.